Now what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna show you about the Apple Loop utility. We can go to our Apple Loop utility by going into our Macintosh hard drive. Once we go on our hard drive, we wanna go to our applications, and from there, go to our utilities. Now once in our utilities, we can double click the Apple Loop and open it up. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna load up a sample that I have on my desktop. The first thing I want to do is I want to look at my sample, and then I want to change it from non-looping to looping, depending on what it is. Now this is a loop, so I want to change it to looping. Once it changes to looping, the most important thing that happens is it actually creates these cuts. These cuts allow it to be cut and shrunk. It allows it to be moved from, you know, like from slower to faster. You can change the BPM by each little cut, not only just by stretching it, but this is like a specific way of stretching it called time slice. And this is the proper way to do it. This is the kind of way that I prefer it done. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna change the BPM just a little bit to around where it is, maybe around 84. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to put it under the drums. And try to pick grooving. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna save all, and what this does is it's gonna save it into my folder with all my other Apple Loops. I'm gonna do edit AIF, and it should be all set. So when I open up my folder right here, I should be able to type new and find my track. What happens is, you might have to restart the program, but what happens is all you really gotta do is just type in the name or whatever one you just put in, and you should be able to load that up into your arranged window and use those in your track.